have something to say. I have more to say. I'm telling you something. It's about now. It's an activity. We're going to make something. It's time for cooking. Today, Miss Janine is going to show you how to do some cooking. It's going to be really yummy.
Hello everybody, it's Mrs. A. Welcome to Home Ec. I bet you're wondering what we're making today. Well, come on in and I'll show you. Let's go and wash our hands first.
Today I'm going to show you how to make easy scones with only three ingredients. So the three ingredients we need is self-raising flour, we need some lemonade, and we need some cream. Okay, so those are the three ingredients. Our equipment we're going to need is a bowl, a knife, a measuring cup, and another little bowl to the side. This is really easy. So the first thing we're going to need is we're going to need 3 cups of self-raising flour. So we take our self-raising flour and we use our measuring cup and we're just going to have 3 cups. 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, that's all we need so far. And now we're going to make a little well in the middle. And a well is where we just make a little hole in there. Just use our knife. Okay, the next thing we need, and we're going to use that same measuring cup, and we are going to measure 1 cup of cream. So we'll just open up the cream. That. Pour the cream in there, and remember we always pour over something so that if we spill anything it goes into the container. So that's our 1 cup of cream, so we're going to put that in our little bowl over there. Okay, and now with the same measuring cup, because we want to get all of that cream in there into our bowl, we're going to do 1 cup of lemonade. Again, we're going to hold that over the bowl, pour that in, and 1 cup of lemonade goes into the cream, like that. Okay, now we're going to take our knife again, and all we're going to do here is we're just going to stir that round, but we're not going to stir it very fast because we want to keep the bubbles in the cream. Okay, because the bubbles is what makes the scones rise. So we're not going to go fast. We're just going to mix it very, very slowly like that. Now, we're going to take that and we're going to pour it into that well in the middle here. And make sure we get all of that cream out of there. Actually, Miss Connor, could we just have a spatula, please? So, and Miss Donna's here, everybody. And we're going to use, I'll just leave that in there, we're going to use the spatula and get all of that out so we've got all of that cream in there. Okay, close that, done with that. Right, so taking that knife again, all we're going to do now is we're going to mix that round. And again, we're not going to go really, really fast because we want to keep the bubbles from the lemonade in the mix so that it will rise in the oven. Okay, so I'm just mixing now. Can you see that? Okay. There we go. So we're mixing it until it comes into a dough, like that. And we're just using a knife, and we're not using a spoon because, like I say, we don't want to squish all those bubbles that are in there. So before I take this out, I'm just going to use use this one again. And now I'm going to scrape all of the flour from the side of the bowl back into the mix. Now it should be a little bit sticky like that, and that's really good. The next thing we need is our baking tray. And now I'm going to show you a little trick. We're going to take some baking paper and we're going to pop that in, and I've cut little slits in the side. Miss Donna has, thank you, Miss Donna. Slits in the side, and we're going to squeeze that into here and bend it over so that when we put our scones in there, they won't stick to the bottom of the pan and give us a lot of washing up. It's going to be really good. So we're going to take a little bit of flour. I might just grab a spoon. Another piece of equipment. So we're going to grab a spoon and we're just going to put a little bit of flour on the bottom like that, so that we have a bit of flour on the bottom. And I'm going to put a little bit of flour on my hands and drop the rest of it on this, because if I put my hands on this without the flour, it's going to stick to my hands. So wipe that out and we're going to pop that in like that. And now comes another trick. Some people like to roll the scones out and then cut them into little circles, but we're going to do another little trick. I'm going to get all that off there. And what we're going to do here is we're just simply going to take those hands that have had the flour in it, and we're just going to, actually, I might put a little bit more flour on the top of that, like that, a bit on my hands. Now what we're going to do, we're just going to press that flat into the corners, like this. Not very, very hard, but we're just really squeezing it out so that it fills up the tray or the pan, like that. Okay, so now it looks just like dough in a pan. But to make it come out as scones, you're going to take that same knife that we had before, we're going to dip it in the flour, and then we're going to cut the scones. So we're going to cut them like this. Oh, I'll leave it like that. And then we're going to cut it this way. And when you cut it like this, we're going to turn it around and cut it in the opposite direction so that they don't all go in one direction. We can do another line there, and then there are your scones. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to take just a little bit more flour again, and we're going to sprinkle that over the top, and then this is ready to go. It's ready to go in the oven. Now the oven needs to be on 220 degrees, and you put this in the middle of the oven. So that's what we're going to do next. So open the oven door, and remember the tray needs to be in the middle. And we're going to pop that in there. Close that up. All right. So now while the scones are in the oven, we will need to beat up some cream and have some strawberry jam to go on top of it. You can put whatever jam you like. So we're going to take our cream and we're going to put it into our bowl. And make sure when you have your cream that you get the cream which is for pouring and whipping, okay? Because there's some creams that aren't for whipping. Okay, we can either use a beater, if an electric beater if you have one, and if you don't have one of those, then a whisk is just as good, but it takes a bit longer. Okay, today I'm going to use the electric beater. So I'll just switch that on, pop that in. Remember that you put it in when it's not working, and then flick it on and slowly raise it to the high speed.
now we've got that thick, and you can see if I turn that upside down, nothing will happen to it. Okay, the scones have been in for about 25 minutes. So before we take them out, we're going to test them to see whether they work. Take our skewer, and you can use a skewer or you can use a fork if you don't have a skewer. We're going to put that in. And if it comes out and there's nothing on the skewer, no bits of dough, that means your scones are cooked. Take this out. And you're going to put it on a tray there, a cooling tray. We're going to cool our scones before we cut them. So with your baking paper, you can lift it out like this. Only adults should be doing this because everything here is very, very hot. So we're going to leave our scones there to cool a bit, and then we're going to slice them and add our jam and cream. We're going to take it from the cooling rack, pop it onto a cutting board. So now what we're going to do is we're going to just simply cut along the actual lines that we made before we baked it. Turn it, you can turn the board, and then cut straight again along the lines, and you have got your lovely fresh three ingredient scones. So you take that out like that, you're going to cut them in half, open them up, and pop them on a plate. We start with our jam, and you can either use a knife or you can use a spoon. Actually, Miss Donna, would you like to do these? Okay. All right, so we're going to take some of the jam and pop it on there. And then we're going to have a dollop of cream on top of that. So there's our lovely cream that we whipped up before. We're going to put a dollop of cream on top of that. Dollop on this one, and there you have it.